Bevacizumab is a monoclonal antivascular endothelial growth factor antibody used in combination with antineoplastic agents for the treatment of many types of cancer. In this video, let's find found. What is bevacizumab? What class of drug is bevacizumab? What is bevacizumab used to treat? Who cannot use bevacizumab? What are the side effects of taking bevacizumab? How does bevacizumab make you feel? How to use bevacizumab? What is bevacizumab? What class of drug is bevacizumab? Bevacizumab, sold under the brand name Avastin among others, is a medication used to treat a number of types of cancers and a specific eye disease. For cancer, it is given by slow injection into a vein and used for colon cancer, lung cancer, glioblastoma, and renal cell carcinoma. Bevacizumab was approved for medical use in the United States in 2004. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is listed for its use in treating eye disease. What is bevacizumab used to treat? As a vascular endothelial growth factor, VEGF, inhibitor, bevacizumab is used in several chemotherapy regimens to treat metastatic colorectal cancer, metastatic, unresectable, locally advanced or recurrent non-squamous non-small cell lung cancer, metastatic renal cell carcinoma, metastatic, persistent, or recurrent cervical cancer, primary peritoneal cancer, epithelial ovarian cancer, fallopian tube cancer, breast cancer, and recurrent glioblastoma. Interestingly, bevacizumab is currently under investigation for the treatment of COVID-19 complications including acute respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS, and acute lung injury, ALI. Who cannot use bevacizumab? Bevacizumab is contraindicated in patients who have hypersensitivity to drug, surgery, major within 28 days, unhealed surgical wounds, severe hemorrhage, recent hemoptysis, GI perforation, uncontrolled hypertension, severe/arterial thromboembolism. What are the side effects of taking bevacizumab? Side effects includes black, tarry stools, bleeding gums, body aches or pain, burning, tingling, numbness, or pain in the hands, arms, feet, or legs, chest pain, discomfort, or tightness, chills, cloudy urine, cough. Pharmacodynamics. Bevacizumab binds circulating vascular endothelial-derived growth factor, VEGF, and blocks it from binding to its associated receptors, effectively blunting downstream signaling. The effects of bevacizumab have been shown to re-establish normal vasculature at the tumor site, resulting in increased nutrient and oxygen supply, while also improving the delivery of chemotherapeutic drugs to the target area. On the other hand, VEGF signaling is a vital component of several processes, including angiogenesis, lymphangiogenesis, blood pressure regulation, wound healing, coagulation, and renal filtration. Although blocking VEGF may inhibit metastatic disease progression, it may also result in unintended effects due to the role of VEGF in several other physiologic processes. How does bevacizumab work? Transcription of the VEGF protein is induced by hypoxia-inducible factor, HIF, in a hypoxic environment. When circulating VEGF binds to VEGF receptors, VEGFR1 and VEGFR2, located on endothelial cells, various downstream effects are initiated. It should be noted that VEGF also binds to the neuropilin coreceptors, NRP1 and NRP1, leading to enhanced signaling. Cancer cells promote tumor angiogenesis by releasing VEGF, resulting in the creation of an immature and disorganized vascular network. The hypoxic microenvironment promoted by cancer cells favors the survival of more aggressive tumor cells and gives rise to a challenging environment for immune cells to respond appropriately. As a result, VEGF has become a well-known target for anti-cancer drugs like bevacizumab. Bevacizumab is a mAb that exerts its effects by binding and inactivating serum VEGF. When bound to the mAb, VEGF is unable to interact with its cell surface receptors, and proangiogenic signaling is inhibited. This prevents formation of new blood vessels, decreases tumor vasculature, and reduces tumor blood supply. Half-life. The half-life of bevacizumab is estimated to be 20 days, range of 11 to 50 days. How to use bevacizumab? Metastatic colorectal cancer. Avastin, Mvasi, Zirabev, Alimzis, Bigzelma. In combination with fluorouracil-based chemotherapy. First-line or second-line treatment for metastatic colorectal carcinoma, MCRC, in combination with fluorouracil, 5-FU, based chemotherapy. Bolus IFL, i.e. irinotecan, 5-FU, leucovorin 5 mg per kg, 4q2 weeks. FOLFOX4, i.e. oxaliplatin, 5-FU, leucovorin 10 mg per kg, 4q2 weeks. In combination with a fluoropyrimidine plus irinotecan or oxaliplatin-based chemotherapy. Second-line treatment of patients with MCRC who have progressed on a first-line bevacizumab-containing regimen. Use in combination with a fluoropyrimidine, for example, 5-FU, capecitabine, plus irinotecan or oxaliplatin-based chemotherapy. 5 mg per kg 4q2 weeks or 7.5 mg per kg 4q3 weeks. Non-small cell lung cancer. Avastin, Mvasi, Zirabev, Alimzis, Bigzelma. Indicated for unresectable, locally advanced, recurrent or metastatic, non-squamous non-small cell lung cancer, NSCLC, in combination with carboplatin and paclitaxel. 15 mg per kg 4q3 weeks. Renal cell carcinoma. Avastin, Mvasi, Zirabev, Alimzis, Bigzelma. Indicated for metastatic renal cell carcinoma in combination with interferon alpha 2a. 10 mg per kg 4q2 weeks, Avastin may be used as monotherapy off-label. Are there specific concerns about bevacizumab and pregnancy? Advice and warnings for the use of bevacizumab during pregnancy. FDA pregnancy category C risk cannot be ruled out. That's all the information about bevacizumab we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.